Hi, in this tutorial we will look at the V-Ray switch material. We will see how we can use it in two ways, a straightforward simple way and a more advanced way. So V-Ray material, basically it's a container of materials. Here I have this teapot and a V-Ray material with a red color is applied to it. If I click on the V-Ray material, I can choose V-Ray switch material. I can choose to keep this existing material as a sub material. Click OK. Here I can see this material here. So basically I have 10 sub materials. So a V-Ray switch material is a container of materials. Now the benefit from it, I can have more than one material here, and I can choose to change the material applied to this object here. For example, if I like to have a variation, or maybe I'm not sure which material I want to apply to this material, to this object. Sometimes I want to do multiple renders with different materials applied to the same object. So I can have these materials here, and then I can choose which material I want to show in the render. For example, here in the switch, I can see the value 0. That means the switch material will apply the material with the index 0. I will add few other materials here to show how this material works. I will add a V-Ray material here, and I will call it green. I will give it a green color. Here I will have another material, call it blue. And another material, yellow. If I render now, the teapot is red because the index here is 0, so the switch material is giving showing the red material on the teapot. If I type 1, green. If I render again, I will have the green material. If I type 3, for example, I can have the yellow. So you get the idea. Now, suppose that I want to make multiple copies from this object, and I want these copies to have different materials applied to them. Different materials from here. So what should I do? I can right click, go to object properties, user defined. I will choose a variable name. You can choose any name you like. I will choose teapot, and I will type equal. And I will give it a number, and I will choose a number between 0 and 9. I will choose 0. Click OK. Now I will make multiple copies. You can choose instance or copy, doesn't matter, because the user defined is not affected by the fact that you're choosing an instance or a copy. So I will create 3 copies. I will right click this one, and I will change it to 1. And this one, 2. And this one, 2, 3. Now, the idea is that I want this teapot to have the red color, this one to have the green, this one to have the blue, and this one to have the yellow. So how can I do that? Click on this button here, go to V-Ray Maps and choose V-Ray User Scalar. Now don't worry about all of these parameters for now, just focus on this one, attribute name. Here you need to use the same variable name. I will copy and paste it here. So now this map will go inside each of these objects, check the user defined tab, and see if there is a variable name with the same name as here. So this map will grab the value of the variable from each of these objects. For example, it will grab the value 0 from this one, it will grab the value 1 from this one, and it will supply it to this switch material here. So basically this map here will tell the switch material to give the first material to this teapot, because this one is 0. It will, and this one, this green material, will go to this teapot because it's 1, and this one for this teapot, and you know, and the last one will have the yellow because the user variable has a value of 3. So let's try to render now. As you can see, it works. Now, for example, I can right click this one and I can give it 0 also. So both of these are red. I can take this one and give it 3. Render again. So, and this one are yellow now. So, and this technique can be useful if you have like multiple proxies. You can choose if you have a proxy, for example, you can give it a user variable with a value and then copy it. And you can load in each of the proxies the same mesh. And if you are already prepared some variations, for example, if it's a tree and you want these trees to have like small variation in their colors, you can prepare different variations from the same tree. And you can load the same mesh in multiple proxies, and then you can have a variation in the rendering. So basically that's it for this material. I hope you like it, and if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next video. Thank you.